The people from the developed countries have got everything else you can think about except one. They are never relaxed. Who is a person from a developed country, just look at the way they walk. Sun is shining, the weather is sweet, yeah. Make you wanna move. When you see us walking like this, don't think we are lazy. We are just relaxed. And that is why we are the only country in the whole world that does not owe money to World Bank. You're dancing, Tina. When the morning, you're the rainbow.
Want you to know, I'm a rainbow too. To the rescue, here I am. President of the World Bank, his name was Wolfenson at that time, to come and check what our problem was. He came, of course, in a hurry. And when he got here, he said, do you have any market? I think he was looking for a stock. You know, I don't know how they complete the sentence. There is a word stock, that's all I know. He said, you have a market? We said, oh yes, we have a very big market here, Owino. Wolfenson went to Owino expecting to find computers and telephones. He was shocked. Sweet potatoes, vegetables, bananas, and a lot of people, all of them talking and nobody listening. All of them moving but going nowhere. Owino is the only place in Uganda where you can hide in public and nobody finds you. So when Wolfenson got there, he said, now what do I do? He said, let me buy something as a souvenir to go and show to people in Washington so they can understand what sort of markets exist in Uganda. He saw a Ugandan woman selling two bunches of bananas. Wolfenson said, I'll buy these. How much is each bunch? It was supposed to be 5,000, but when the woman looked at the skin, the price went up. And she said, 10,000. Wolfenson said, okay, give me both of them, and pulled out a 20,000 shilling note. The woman said, what? Said, yeah, give me, I will take both of them. And the woman said, no. Wolfenson said, why? The woman said, if you take both of them today, what will I do tomorrow? You take one so that I have something to keep me busy. You leave this man. Wolfenson said, let me go to Lake Victoria and find out what fishermen do in Uganda. He went to Lake Victoria, found a Ugandan fisherman lying under a tree, 10 o'clock in the morning, and Wolfenson looked at him and said, hi man, what's up? The Ugandan looked at Wolfenson and said, the sky. And Wolfenson said, what do you do every day? The Ugandan said, I'm a fisherman. And what the hell are you doing here? The lake is there. You are here with your torn clothes in the morning. Why don't you go out and catch fish? The Ugandan said, I fished yesterday. And how many fish did you catch? Three. What did you do with the three? We ate one at home. I gave one to my neighbor. We are going to eat the last one tonight. Tomorrow I go back to the lake. Simple economics. You go when the things are finished. Wolfenson said, since you have the fish to eat tonight, go to the lake and catch more fish. The Ugandan said, why kill the fish in advance? Let it have an extra day of life. I don't need it yet. Wolfenson said, go catch the fish and sell it. The Ugandan said, what? Said, sell the fish, get money. And the Ugandan said, and then? You use that money to buy a fishing net and catch more fish. The Ugandan said, and then? Use the money, buy a motorized boat, catch more fish. And then? Sell it and get a lot of money. And then? When you get a lot of money, you will become very rich. And then? When you become very rich, you will relax. And the Ugandan looked at Wolfenson from the bottom to the top and said, what do you think I'm doing now? I'm a rainbow too. World Bank meeting and said, ladies and gentlemen, forget, Ugandans will never pay. The fellows are not even aware that they owe us money. They are in another world, too relaxed. You delete the debts, let the world go on. That's how we survived. Today we are debt-free. To relax, if development is taking away from your capacity to relax, leave it. It's no good.